Yep, so I'm not doing Kotlin code anymore. I still don't see it. It sounds like you just calculate all variants. I'm talking about MeasureTags comment. Like, you try digits 1, 0 for what? For first digit, right? For each. Or you mean like there are less Z values than inputs? Ah. That might be the case. It might be the case, yeah. No, there are 9 digits and 9 Z values. So basically, no, I don't understand. Sorry. Okay, let's go to day 25. At least I will see one picture, right? Oh, okay. Already bored. The bottom of the ocean trench, the last place that's light case could be. Your submarine's experimental antenna still isn't boosted enough to detect the case, but they must be here. Blah 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 blah. The cucumbers, yeah. Cool. One always moves east while the other always moves south. Each location contains most one sea cucumber. The remaining locations are empty. The submarine helpfully generates a map of the situation you puzzle into, for example. Well, I hope so. Every stave of sea cucumber is east facing her to attempt to move forward one location. Then the sea cucumber is the south facing herd, attempt to move one location. When a herd moves forward, every sea cucumber in the herd first simultaneously considers whether there is a sea cucumber in each location, even another sea cucumber facing in the same direction. And then every sea cucumber facing in each location simultaneously moves into one step from the rightmost could be moved. After the next step, two sea cucumber could move in a single step, the east facing herd moves first. And south facing herd moves. So given this situation, after a single step of the sea cucumber on the left of the south facing. Okay, so this guy's moves and then two of these guys moves. Okay. And it's looped. Well, in the submarine, the sea cucumber needs to stop moving. Again, consider the first example. Blah blah blah. In this example, stop moving after. So they get locked at some point. No sea cucumber move. Okay, cool. Sounds cool. Maybe even visualization would be cool. Yeah, it's much easier, definitely. And. This is good, right? Let me have a quick break and then we'll probably draw a visualization of this thingy. It looks cool, yeah. 2 minutes. 2 minutes. Not sure how I mute. How do I mute? Okay, let's get started. This is our example, right? So let's save this as well. Day 25 example. What if we use this as the state? What if we keep state as a string? It would be not very convenient to work with, right? I'm just tired of using this arrays of arrays and stuff like that. So basically for no, it's parse. Basically, it's an array of arrays of characters, right? State. So to move right, we basically do So if this is this and the right is dot, then we have dot, right? Now we also have need left actually. Right. Otherwise we don't change, right? Okay, so this is kind of our state or move right. Also move down, right? Move down line up. Upper is and lines y plus deck height, not height, this is down. This is move down. Okay, and depending on top, oh, let's call them top and bottom. If top this, where this is bottom. Okay. We need visualization for sure, and we'll have it in a sec. But first, let's make sure we can write the proper algorithm. Let's parse input. Okay, we'll basically reduce. We start with lines and turn number, which is 0. Well, kind of, let's do a loop. I'm not sure what we are going to be reducing. Okay, so lines is parse input, right? Turn is 0, let lines move lines, move right, move down. Okay, if equals lines, lines, turn, otherwise, record lines prime, int turn. Okay. So if we did it correctly, it's just 4. This is not, should be 4, should be 58. Interesting. Okay, so this is where we need visualization probably. Let's create a new, what is the latest that we had? Okay, so this is gonna be day 25. Okay. Window state args state or print state state pixel size bounds with chart basically this is count first state, count state, right? This is pixel size, translate. Basically, and state y x, right? So in this case, we're going to have three colors, draw a rectangle, the 25 GUI. Okay. Make window. The problem name, sea cucumber. Control. Yes, 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 yes. We have GUI.clj, so I want to copy this new file. 21. Well, actually, it doesn't have to be this. We can just finder, move it one step up, GUI, script run, GUI, okay, like this, okay, do stop, script. Okay, connect, there is no window, right? Window close. Yeah, because we don't. Yeah, and this is our window. It displays something. Okay, this is bigger input. Cool. You probably don't see chat, right? Let me move it here, maybe. Or here. I don't know. But anyways, it seems to work. Let's see. Let's actually do the same loop as here, but this red sleep, don't need this. Yeah, I should change colors actually, because... Okay. I actually should say maybe state, state 2 primes is going to be... prime. Equals what? Could it be the case that... Oh, I forgot actually to reset state times, right? And I actually want to do it kind of here. Huh. Nothing happens, right? For some reason. Okay, something is not working, we also need some color palette. So how about this will be our water? Right. The cucumber moving right going to be say this. And the cucumbers moving down will be say this. Well, kind of. Not too contrast enough, right? Let's use this. Yeah, I think this is better. Yeah, I think this should work. Oh my fucking god. Sorry. This is because this is why it doesn't work, right? Okay, so it kind of works. It kind of works. Okay, and if we say input, kind of works as well. I have a feeling like they move to the right, but they don't move down, right? For some reason. Okay, let's see. Move down lines. Okay, yeah, fuck. And top X and slack X. This is why. This. Yeah, it worked. Yeah, it's kind of beautiful. Wow. It's very beautiful, actually. Fuck me. Wow. But anyways, 57, we're probably off by one, right? Supposed to be 58. Mm-hmm. 523. And that's the right answer. Yahoo! Slay keys detected. According to the console, the key are directly under the submarine. You landed right on them. Using robotic arm on the submarine, you move the slay keys into airlock. Now you just need to get them to Santa in time to save Christmas. You check your clock. It is Christmas. There is no way you can get them back to the surface in time. And just as you start to lose hope, you notice a button on the slay keys. Remote start. You can start the sleigh from the bottom of the ocean. You just need some way to boost the signal from the keys so it actually reaches the sleigh. Good turning. I think the submarine has experimental antenna. You definitely need 50 stars to boost it that far, though. The experimental antenna control console lights up again. Energy source detected integrating. Yay, we started it. Yes? You use all 50 stars to boost the signal and remotely start the slay. Now you have just find your way back to the server. Did you know crap submarines come with colored lights? Congratulations, you finished every puzzle. Yeah, there's no part two, apparently. How cool was that? Should we make this triangles or rectangles? Pretty cool. I think they're cool. My website, author Twitter. So this is a guy who does Advent of Code. Here was future project I found on Twitter. I highlighted the Easter eggs in each puzzle. Just in case you missed any, hover your mouse. Okay, go check your calendar. And always disappointing there is no part two of day 25. I'm quite happy. Happy Christmas, everyone! Yay! We did it. We actually did it, which is good. This is my first event of code. There is this was Matrix reference, right? Okay, I don't know what this is supposed to mean. But this looks cool though, right? Let's run it again, actually. It looks like snow. How cool is that? Okay, so this task is very satisfying, actually. Yeah, I agree. It is satisfying. Sub-zero pattern. Should we try? Unfortunately, there is no way to. Okay, let me make it. Should we try a few more? Like here? How long count? How long is this? Wait, what? No, no, not input. One 37. Okay. For VY range 137. For the X range 137, around ends, and we okay, and we can do here, for example, random input. Okay. This was not as impressive. But maybe we need more empty space. Let's see. Yeah, seems like it, right? This is random, but it's very similar to what we got in the problem. So I assume they did something like they generated the map like that, by using two times empty space and one time each direction, kind of. If too empty, it could move forever. Yeah, I suppose. Let's actually add one more to the empty and see what happens. I wonder if this is a forever case, or is it going to stop at some point? Let me make it bigger. Yeah, it feels like this will be going forever, right? Looks like Christmas though. I like that the last problem actually looks like something like Christmas, right? It has Christmassy theme, something. It seems like because I'm sharing this. This is not very good for compression, right? The image. So my face is also like all that. There's too much information in this. So because the quality of the whole picture goes down, like the stream picture. The guys say it's Byham Middleton Levine traffic model. Okay. Well, makes sense, I guess. Okay. Looks cool, but doesn't end, unfortunately. Part two, there is no part two. Let's just return this for part two, right? We have main 25. Let's stop. The whole year, all 25 tasks for the whole year. Oh, fuck, we need this to fix this warning. It was in day 24.clg, right? Yeah. Refer closure. So yeah, like this. Let's see how long does it take to solve all problems. When computers does it, computer does it. I always don't know where to look here. 70, I don't know. Something like that. There is a solution written in Rust that solves the old days in 17 milliseconds. Cool. Well, we didn't always optimize for speed, right? I don't know. Yeah. Rust is better, clearly. Okay, day 25, day 25 example, run GUI, day 25, day 25 GUI. Okay, year 2021, day 25. And we are done with this year, and probably with advent of code in general, because I am so tired, This wasn't the easiest year. Okay, so this looks, 2020 looks slightly better, right? So like 1, 2, 3, 4, let's say 5 hard days, right? And here only 2 hard days. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. Like 2019 also pretty hard. 2018 is pretty hard. This is super hard. Like start popping up like super hard tasks for the rest of the Christmas. Oh my god. Yeah, 24th was weekend, right? It was Friday, actually. Well, I was about to say like this looks okay to me, but again, this is 4 hours tops, right? And this is like just one topped at 1 hour, and this like first 100 people solved it in 4 hours. So no fucking way I'm going to this. This is also 3 hours. No. This is topped by 1 hour. This is probably the most balanced kind of day 24 solution is quite fast. Let's compare. Yeah. Well, mine does the same, because like I have no idea how to turn it into programs, so I'm just print two numbers. They say 2018 day 15 is probably the most terrible one. 2018 day 15, like, but it took 2.5 hours. Actually, I think I solved it, right? Because I did 2018 and I did day 15. I probably even did it on stream. I remember this is goblins, right? How long did it take? Let's see. No. And this. Okay, yeah, it doesn't matter. Okay, so we need day 15, day 18. Day 15, this one, 5 hours, 6 hours, okay. Yeah, for some reason, I don't remember it as being something terrible. Like, I don't remember being exhausted by it for some reason. Maybe because I did like lots of visualizations there, and probably like most of the problem was, and I didn't have this template for visualization, so I had to invent it. Maybe. But yeah, it took 6 hours, but it was fun, I suppose. I don't know. Oh, we even Googled some helps, right? Yeah, okay, whatever. Anyways, this concludes our adventure. I would say and I think I should get back to work. Thanks for coming to the stream, it was fun. I probably would have abandoned it if not for the streams and the support and the company. Thanks guys, have a good holidays. On ECFPC, yeah, maybe. We'll see if I recover by that time. Okay, bye-bye.